to say.
I am Iron Man.
What's in the box?
Flash, I love you, but we only have 14 hours to save the Earth.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass. And I'm all out of bubblegum.
And here we go.
I hate California. I want to go to the East Coast.
I want to go where culture is, like
how
New
in the
York.
World did I raise such
or at least
snob.
Connecticut or New Hampshire, where writers live in the
get
woods.
Get into those schools anyway.
Mom!
You should just go to City College. You know, with your work ethic, just go to City College and then to jail and then back to City College and then maybe you'd learn to pull yourself up and not expect everybody to do everything.
So, it's the best reviewed movie of all time according to the Rotten Tomatoes Tomato-Metre. It's been nominated for all the big categories in the Oscars and had four big wins at this year's Golden Globes. It's won pretty much every major independent film award. It's destined to be part of future school curriculum programs, and if it could be nominated for the President of the United States, it would probably win in a landslide victory. But the big question that needs to be asked is, does this authentic feeling coming-of-age slice of Americana resonate outside of the States?
You're tired, wait, you sit down.
I'm not tired.
You were dragging your feet.
You are so infuriated.
Please stop yelling.
I'm not yelling.
Oh,
it's perfect.
Do you love it?
Lady Bird has finally hit Australian shores, and it's a story about a teenage girl who is literally from the wrong side of the tracks, just trying to get through high school, get a university placement, get along with her parents, and just get by. Set in 2002, the film is a semi-autobiographical endeavor from first-time writer-director Greta Gerwig. Starring Saoirse Ronan and Roseanne's Laurie Metcalf, we get some genuinely raw emotional performances from everyone involved. With splashes of relatable family moments spread throughout the tight 90-minute runtime, the film tackles adolescence, growing up poor, Catholic schooling, teenage friendship groups, and trying to fit in head-on.
If you want to read it, we can go down to the public library.
I want to read it in bed.
That's something that rich people do. We're not rich people.
The film has a very authentic charm and feel to it. It feels very real and doesn't succumb to the cliches the same way it might have in the hands of another director. Lady Bird is very much an indie darling. It has all the elements you've come to expect from an indie film. Fixed cameras with tight shots, sharp editing, an acoustic soundtrack, and warm tones that just make the movie feel like it's a memory or a Polaroid. The film is so indie that it even manages to slip in the C word every now and then, and I'm sure that somewhere out there, there is an indie film pervert with a spare room filled with copies of Lady Bird, just so that they can go in there at the end of each night and just lie in them and make indie film angels. Director Greta Gerwig and cinematographer Sam Levy have taken some painstaking steps to make the film look and feel like it's from 2002. And even though that doesn't seem like that long ago, it's still over 15 years ago. The time taken to select the music, posters, discussion points of the characters all feel very Americana. However, the attention to detail does mean that if you don't have a firm working knowledge of America, then some of the references may be lost to Australian audiences. For example, I don't really know that much about Sacramento, and the film does spend a lot of time reflecting on all things Sacramento. It doesn't have a major impact on your enjoyment of the film, but it might go some way to explaining why American audiences have really just lapped up this film.
Yeah, well, you know your mom's... They're fake! Totally fake!
She made one bad decision at 19!
Two bad decisions!
At the end of the day, you'll laugh, you'll cringe, and you'll be comparing the film to your own adolescent experiences. Overall, it's a fun, charming, and bittersweet tale that only has minor elements that might be lost on non-American audiences. For Oscar season movies, I still prefer Three Billboards Outside Missouri, but Lady Bird is definitely a film to watch, be it in the cinemas or when it arrives at homes. And if nothing else, we have an exciting new female writer-director's future films to look forward to.
And we won't succeed.
I want you to be the very best version of yourself that you can be.
What if this is the best version? What I'd really like is to be on Math Olympiad.
But math isn't something you're terribly strong in.
That we know of yet.